38 at Chicago Stadium, and he was able to do it. Quite a performance.
He won his second straight slam dunk contest. The very next day, he scored 40 points and was named MVP of that 1988 All-Star game. And then last season in San Antonio, he led the East to victory, won his second star, Most Valuable Player Award. So, Matt, for Michael Jordan, again, it is a chance to add to that legend. And it should be pointed out, he
and Garnett, Chris Webber, and Christian Laettner, who are three dominant personalities for their surging teams. And then there's Eddie Jones and Tom Gugliotta, two guys who are overshadowed on their own teams, but are really the
arena, and Jeff Shreve.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 1997 NBA All-Star Game. The 1997 NBA All-Stars, first the Western Conference. He's making his All-Star coaching debut from the Houston Rockets, Rudy Tomjanovich. The assistant coaches from the Houston Rockets are Larry Smith, Bill Barry, and Jim Boylan, and the trainer from the Los Angeles Lakers, Gary Vitti. And now the players from the Western Conference. A former Rookie of the Year and the 1995 All-Star Game MVP from the Sacramento Kings, Mitch Richmond. He's led his team in scoring for three seasons, and this year leads in points, steals, assists, and minutes from the Golden State Warriors, Latrell Sprewell. One of the league's most explosive guards, making his All-Star debut from the Los Angeles Lakers, Eddie Jones. This fifth year forward leads his team in points, rebounds, and minutes played from the Minnesota Timberwolves, Tom Gugliotta. This 6'10 forward consistently ranks among the league leaders in field goal percentage. One of the top six men in the league, from the Dallas Mavericks, Chris Gatling. This versatile 12-year veteran boosts the Sonics with outside shooting, rebounding, and excellent all-around play. From the Seattle Supersonics, Detlef Schrempf. This 20-year-old second-year forward has the Timberwolves challenging for their first playoff spot. From the Minnesota Timberwolves, Kevin Garnett. Unable to participate and not here today, from the Los Angeles Lakers, Shaquille O'Neal. And unable to participate from the Houston Rockets, Clyde Drexler. Also from the Houston Rockets, Charles Barkley. And now the starting lineup. This four-time All-Star leads his team in assists, steals, and minutes. From the Seattle Supersonics, Gary Payton. This guard is the all-time leader in assists and steals. From the Utah Jazz, John Stockton. He's the most prolific shot blocker in league history, playing in his 12th All-Star game. From the Houston Rockets, Hakeem Olajuwon. This powerful forward has delivered a record 9 consecutive seasons with 2,000 points from the Utah Jazz, Karl Malone. This forward has raised his scoring and rebounding averages in each of his 7 NBA seasons from the Seattle Supersonics, Sean Kemp. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1997 Western Conference All-Stars. And now let's meet the 1997 NBA Eastern Conference All-Stars. The head coach of the Eastern Conference All-Stars from the Detroit Pistons, Doug Collins. Assistant coaches also from the Detroit Pistons, Johnny Box, Alvin Gentry, John Hammond, and Brian James. The trainer is from your Cleveland Cavaliers, Jerry Briggs. He played in every game in his first 3 pro seasons. From the Milwaukee Bucks, Ben Baker. This versatile forward is enjoying a career year in scoring and rebounding, making his All-Star debut from the Atlanta Hawks, Christian Laettner. One of the top perimeter shooters in the league and making his 2nd consecutive All-Star appearance from the Charlotte Hornets, Glenn Rice. The only remaining member from the Pistons back-to-back NBA championship, he's making his 6th All-Star appearance from the Detroit Pistons, Joe Dumars. This exciting forward leads his team in points, blocks, and rebounds. The first-time All-Star from the Washington Bullets, Chris Webber. Making his 4th All-Star appearance from the Miami Heat, Tim Hardaway. He's among the league leaders in scoring, assists, and steals, and leads the league in free throw shooting from your Cleveland Cavaliers, Terrell Brandon. Injured and unable to participate from the Miami Heat, Alonzo Mourning. Also injured and unable to participate from the New York Knicks, Patrick Ewing. And now the starting lineup for the Eastern Conference. Playing in his 6th straight All-Star game with a 1994 MVP performance from the Chicago Bulls, Scottie Pippen. This versatile star has led his team to its best ever start this year. From the Detroit Pistons, Grant Hill. He's led the league in block shots for a record 3 straight seasons. From the Atlanta Hawks, Dikembe Mutombo. This 4th-year guard is a 3-time All-Star. From the Orlando Magic, Penny Hardaway. The 4-time league and finals MVP and 2-time All-Star MVP from the Chicago Bulls, Michael Jordan. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1997 NBA All-Stars.
Has this now become all-star tradition? The target tonight, Dikembe Mutombo of the Atlanta Hawks. A year ago in San Antonio, you may recall, right before the introduction, Michael Jordan attempted to pull down the pants of Penny Hardaway to the amusement of the rest of the squad. And moments ago, backstage, yes, the combination of Hardaway and Jordan ganging up on Mutombo.
How reflective, though, of just the distance that Penny has come from victim to accomplice in just 1 year.
And we are set for the opening tip. Hugh Evans, Bill Oakes, Ron Garrison are the officials. The East leading the All-Star Series 29-17. The East and West have split the last 10 games. At one point in the early 1980s, the East won 5 in a row. And last season in San Antonio, the East defeated the West 129-118. Now, the problem here, as I see it today, at the Gund Arena scoreboard, is it capable? Because Mike Fratello coaches the Cleveland Cavaliers in a different brand of basketball. Is that third digit, does it light up? Can they hit the century mark?
Mark, maybe they'll just call the game when it's 70-65.
Everybody will feel right at home. And it's called white ball. That is the East squad with Hardaway and Jordan in the backcourt. Hill is up front with Mutombo and Pippen.
Well, the strategy for both teams, such as it is run fast, jump high, shoot straight. And Scottie Pippen can't get the first one and somehow or other keep those spectacular passes near the court.
And this is Gary Payton of the Seattle Sonics getting it back from Karl Malone. And the East back to the offense.
Beautiful ball movement that time, the give and go. Critical elements for success today, Mark. Playing time. Always a good idea to bribe the coach to get you out there. A lot more. The transition game, the ability to get up and down the court, and then individual offense. You have to be able to make it happen off your own dribble.
John Stockton of the Utah Jazz to Sean Kemp of the Sonics. Gary Payton to Sonics in the West starting lineup. Hakeem Olajuwon putting moves on to Dikembe Mutombo, did not have the shot. Shot clock down to one. And here comes Pippen. Drive and he's fouled. So Penny Hardaway will go to the line. Penny Hardaway has played only 19 games this season due to knee injuries, averaging 20 points, 5 assists for the Orlando Magic, a team that is coming on fast.
And playing very well, not only because Penny's back, Nick Anderson is back, Ronnie Cicely is having a terrific season. Everything's falling into place for the Magic. You can remember Penny's first All-Star game, actually 3 years ago, very nervous in the first half, and has come out ever since then and been much more aggressive, not worrying or deferring to anybody. A couple of mismatches out on the floor. West has 2 point guards in Stockton and Payton, the only two on their team. Two big forwards for the West and two versatile ball handling small forwards for the East.
Picked off the fake. Olajuwon picked up on the double team. There is some defense, guys, being played out there here in the early going. But a three for Payton.
Off the nice pass from Hakeem. Talking to the Dream before the game, Mark. The fast ended for him today. He lost about 5 pounds during the course of the month of Ramadan. And he got to eat today for the first time. He's feeling great.
That was Michael Jordan's first shot attempt. And here is Grant Hill unleashing his first. It's the East 4, the West 3.
That's a tough matchup for Sean Kemp, having to try to guard Grant Hill out of the point. You'd rather see Grant take that jump shot because he's about the best in the league at beating you off the dribble.
Hakeem with the good forearm up high.
And a foul is called. Bill Oakes with the call as you take a look back at the pass from Hakeem.
Hakeem is so talented, Mark. He's able to step out and play that high post going up against the much, much taller Dikembe Mutombo.
Jordan! Fouled by Payton.
Here's that nightmare matchup for Sean Kemp, trying to watch Grant Hill. Has to give ground, has to back up, but he could at least offer a hand up in his face.
Michael Jordan, who has some very pleasant memories of big games that he's played here in Cleveland. Had his career high 69 at the Richfield Coliseum.
And Gary Payton's got to go, what did I do wrong? Last Sunday, he had to watch Michael Jordan drill him and others for 45, and here he has to guard him again in All-Star competition.
Michael, the practice yesterday, told me that he's a little bit more relaxed this year. Last year, after the two-year layoff, he came out so focused, so intense. He's going to enjoy himself a little bit more with all the festivities. There's been a smile on Michael's face all weekend.
Hakeem Olajuwon has tied the game at five.
Hakeem Olajuwon, one of three Houston Rockets All-Stars, but Clyde Drexler is finally sitting up because of injury. Jordan tried to twist that one home. Here comes Payton. The look away to Stockton.
Yes. And the West leads 7-5.
Johnson on the receiving end of a couple of passes earlier in the game when it first started. He was in the post, of course. Got a nice pass from Sean Kemp. And there, a good feed from Payton.
But Johnson's not used to playing with a lot of guys who handle the ball in the up and down game.
What a tumble! Consecutively, another opportunity.
Oh, almost a hat trick.
The game tied at 7.
But they held Karl Malone. Karl Malone, who has been into it verbally from the introductions today with Scottie Pippen. Karl got out in transition, and Scottie just reached out and grabbed him, held him. Obvious foul. Foul was called on Jordan. That is his first.
And here's Kemp from long range. And a three for Sean Kemp, who has been struggling recently, but he's been hitting the three. He's been looking for the three more frequently this season. Went through the hands of Mutombo.
Beautiful passing by Kemp. I think that's one of the great things about the All-Star game, Marv, is the creativity that you see, not only in shooting, but in the ball movement as well.
3.5 minutes gone by in the first quarter. That was intended for Jordan. Marv Albert with Matt Dukas. And Bill Walton will be joined later on the sidelines by Ahmad Rashad and Jim Gray. Hill fronting Kemp. Call for the foul. A push on Grant Hill of the Detroit Pistons.
Marv, you talked with Matt earlier about the advantages for the East. It looks like the East has the 6-7 range dominance with Jordan and Pippen, Grant Hill and Penny. But the West has the 6-10 to 6-11 range dominance with Kemp and Karl Malone, Christian Laettner. And of course, the new guys off the bench with Kevin Garnett.
With his teammate Kemp. And it did not work.
Well, we've seen two alley-oopers so far. Nobody can get a hand on them yet. They're going to have to adjust their passes. The problem the East is having right now, they really don't know who the primary ball handler is. Everybody's taking their turn because Grant Hill has it. He's used to handling. Penny Hardaway gets the jumper there. He's used to handling for Orlando. Of course, Pippen for Chicago.
It is the West 10 and the East 9. And Kemp fires one up. Well, Karl Malone on the rebound. Obviously, Sean Kemp following the philosophy that you laid out in our opening remarks.
Shoot every time. The coach is not going to yank you for getting over-aggressive on the offensive end.
Oh, Hill stepped out of bounds. He backed up trying to handle that pass.
Scottie Pippen in transition is going to get to the hoop at the last minute. Realizes that everybody else has stopped waiting for the whistle, just threw it up, and then the alley-oop a little bit too far. Now, Sean Kemp can get in the air with anybody. If you overthrow him, it's a little hard.
Hakeem Olajuwon showing the outside touch. He's hit his first two shots. The West with a 14-9 lead. Mitch Richmond of the Sacramento Kings, MVP of the All-Star game 2 years ago, has come on, replacing John Stockton. Here's Jordan, rebounded by Malone. So Michael missing on his first three-shot attempt. Payton directing traffic, gives it up to Richmond. For three, yes. Well, off the bench, Mitch Richmond, who's averaging 25 a game, hitting his first shot. Payton with the steal.
What a great try by Jordan. He looked sidelined, tried to fake out Payton. Payton didn't bite.
And Jordan with the rebound. He has Hill ahead of the field. You can enter that one of the slam dunk contest 24 hours a bit late.
Grant, just getting started really in his All-Star career, has learned quickly, don't get back on defense.
These are valuable lessons that you have been passing on, Bill.
I learned the hard way, Marv.
Well, Kemp with a look-away pass broke it up. And now Payton with the ball fake. 5:45 remaining. First quarter. It's the West 17-11. And the ball back to the West. Timeout has been called. Gary Payton certainly enjoying his new teammates, leading the break, pitching out to his left to Mitch Richmond. And Richmond, who just came off the bench, able to drill the three. And at the other end, the breakaway for Grant Hill of the Pistons. His third All-Star selection in his 3 years, 3 for 3, and he does it with the reverse. We'll be back at the Gums in Cleveland in a moment. 50th anniversary celebration season of the NBA. We flash back to the 62 All-Star game in St. Louis, and Philadelphia's Wilt Chamberlain lit up the West squad for 42 points, an All-Star record. Will also with 24 rebounds in the game. The West won it anyway, 150-130. There is 13-time NBA All-Star Wilt Chamberlain. Let's go to Ahmad.
All right, thanks, Rob. I'm here with Wilt Chamberlain, one of the greatest players ever played the game, but I guess I could say that about 50 times, but when I'm talking about you, big fella, a little bit more enthusiasm.
Well, I appreciate that. It's nice though to be here, but I want to say one thing. You know, they keep talking about all of us being great and so on and so forth, but our chances would have never came if it wasn't for the originators of the NBA, and we got to say thank you to them and the NBA in continuance of what they're doing, because they've given us all a chance to show our stuff and make a lot of money and have a lot of fun in life.
Well, one of the great things I saw yesterday was that I saw you and Michael Jordan talking. Now, I didn't know that you guys had never met. What was going on in that conversation?
Well, I just went over to say hello to him, and I was like everybody else. I meant all. So I went over to say hello and said that we had to get together and talk sometime, which he wanted to do. And it was nice. I mean, most people would have thought that we had met, but no, I don't play golf, you understand? And he doesn't play volleyball, so, but, you know, here we are now.
42 points you scored in 62. Anybody going to top that?
I don't think so today. If so, they have to get 27 rebounds, too. I don't know.
Oh, you threw that in. 42 and 27. Back to you, Marv.
All right, thanks, Ahmad. Terrell Brandon of the Cavaliers has checked in for the first time and hit his first shot attempt, and off the foul call. We have just under 5 minutes remaining in this first quarter, and the West up by the count of 19-13. Latrell Sprewell of the Warriors, who just came on, was called for that foul.
Yeah, Wilt not only remembers the stats of every All-Star game that he played in, he remembers the stats of every game he played in and all of his teammates combined. You know, Wilt was hinting this week that he might be able to play, if asked, 5 to 10 minutes at 60 years of age. He does that about every 5 years.
Most of the top 50 players who've been together all weekend, they've been approaching guys like Kevin McHale, now running the Timberwolves. And he said, I can play 10 minutes a game, Kevin. Bring me back.
Well, the West off that drive by Payton, now leading by the score of 21-13. Chris Webber of the Washington Bullets, who just came on, missing that shot. Jordan hit the floor. So the East now with Webber able to hit. Webber up front with Baker and Brandon Hardaway and Jordan. This is Tom Gugliotta of the Minnesota Timberwolves shooting over Vin Baker. Jordan with a quick pass, and then Webber lost it.
Chris will learn quickly to take that one all the way.
This is the Gary Payton fourth All-Star game, and every one of them, he really loves to play in these games and generally gets everybody involved. That time he saw the opening all by himself, but he really plays this game to try to do as well as he can, try to help the team win, try to get everybody involved.
And he goes to the Los Angeles Lakers for the first time. Nice move by Gugliotta. Tom Gugliotta, fifth year out of North Carolina State. A member of those vastly improved Minnesota Timberwolves, who now have two All-Stars in Gugliotta and 20-year-old Kevin Garnett. Flip Sanders, the coach of the Timberwolves, said, now there's pressure on me. I have two All-Stars.
Well, when you watch the T-Wolves, it's a joy. The style that they play, the enthusiasm, the electricity in the crowd in Minnesota, it's all come together.
know, his wife was the one putting pressure on him, mentioning that he had two All-Stars. He said, hey, how do you think they became All-Stars? It's his coaching. But he is absolutely giddy at the prospects of Kevin Garnett, at the potential that he has, the leadership, the maturity, just one.
Plus, young Stephon Marbury, who like Garnett, is a prodigy. Just unbelievable talent.
Mark, in talking to all the guys who were here for the first time, when you come out of high school and on to college, some of the guys don't even go to college anymore, but they all think that they're just going to step right in and be here initially. And then it's a humbling experience when it doesn't happen the very first time. And then they realize after watching Jordan and Pippen and all the all-time guys, how hard you have to work. Then they get back to it, and you have to give all the credit in the world to Gugliotta and Leitner and these guys who have come really from the depths now to the peak of the mountain.
You mentioned the jump from high school in the case of a Garnett or a Kobe Bryant of the L.A. Lakers, who won the slam dunk competition last night. But in the case of Garnett and Marbury and Bryant, not only do they have magnificent skills, but they are very mature young men, and that's the major difference.
And coachable, and like to play, and want to learn, and want to play at both ends of the floor. They have learned from some of the great players like Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, that you got to play defense as well.
Gugliotta with the rebound. Tom Gugliotta with a second field, and a steal. Gugliotta gets it out. Garnett could not put him down. The West leading 26-17. Pass from Tim Hardaway picked off. Here comes Eddie Jones behind the back for Latrell Sprewell.
Wow, now, you know, remember Chris Webber and Sprewell, very tight friends at Golden State. I think you let him get in there.
Hardaway and Brandon now play in the backcourt. Brandon. Cleveland loves it. Terrell Brandon in his second straight All-Star appearance, averaging 20 points, 6 assists for the Cavaliers. Sprewell drills it. So the West up 31-19. That's a three for Latrell Sprewell.
The game really heating up offensively. But back to your point about the young guys and the maturity, my experience has been that the better the player, the more he wants discipline in his program. And that's what type of skill, that's what kind of maturity these young players have exhibited at this All-Star game.
Garnett, played by Webber. Garnett looking for the step, pulls it back. Rebounded by Webber.
Not a lot of shot blockers out there. Time to get all the way to Chris Webber. Really having trouble getting his shoot time.
And then Baker rebounded. A foul is called. And a timeout is taken.
Well, the number one thief in the NBA, Eddie Jones, showing you why. Right in the passing lane, picking off an easy one there. Handling the ball in the middle of the break. Fancy behind the back pass, as Eddie Jones has really developed his all-around game. And Latrell Sprewell can really do this. Take it to the hole.
Well, always a host of notables at the NBA All-Star Game. Fits the capacity crowd, heavyweight champion Evander Holyfield. Olympic double gold medalist Michael Johnson. And another gold medalist, Bill Murray, in his own mind. And we go to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Marv. I'm joined by Charles Barkley. He's in his 11th All-Star game, second one he's had to miss, and he's got David Robinson Jr. here on the bench. Daddy David sitting behind us. He also heard from San Antonio. Charles, how difficult to sit out an All-Star game, and when will you be back?
I'm ready to go Tuesday. I'm looking forward to going back to my team. We've been struggling. We got to get back on track. But, you know, this has been the most fun All-Star weekend I've had since my first game. Getting a chance to hang out with those other 50 players, it was one of the most emotional times of my life. And this has been a perfect weekend.
You really were almost like a little kid. You had your book and you had all of them sign it, didn't you?
Well, I think for two reasons. Number one, the black guys took all the chances and made it possible for us guys to have to flourish the way we are today. And all the other guys total, they brought the NBA to where it is today. And we owe them a great deal of gratitude and respect.
Charles, do you begin to cherish these moments just a little bit more when it gets put into a historic perspective like it has this weekend?
I think a little bit, but also I think as you get down to the end of your career and you realize you're not going to play in that many more All-Star games or you're close to the end of it, you know, it becomes more significant.
Now the the West has a big lead right now, it doesn't seem as though they're missing your talent.
Well, I think, you know, I don't show up my game until the fourth quarter, so the first three quarters, they won't miss me.
All right, congratulations, Charles. We look forward to seeing you in the next couple of weeks.
Thank you.
Marv?
All right, thank you, Jim. Some of you may have seen Meet the Press earlier today here on NBC. Among Tim Russert's guests, Charles Barkley, NBA Deputy Commissioner Russ Granick had contacted Charles about this last week, and Barkley said to Russ, finally, I'll be talking to my audience. And the Rockets will certainly welcome Charles back. Clyde Drexler will be out for a while, though, but Barkley, as you heard, will be back Tuesday. Houston has lost six straight games. The West 34 and the East 21 with a half minute left in this first quarter. Here's Glenn Rice, who has been on a tear for the Charlotte Hornets. And back comes Mitch Richmond. Eddie Jones. That was intended for Kevin Garnett. We're down to 23 seconds in the quarter. Tim Hardaway has had a sensational season for Pat Riley and the surprising Miami Heat. Walking it up, working the clock down. Down to 10 seconds in this first quarter. Brandon eluding Springwell, blocked by Scholes. And the East will inbound with 2:03 seconds remaining in the quarter.
Eddie Jones defensively, that's the same job he did on Jordan to close out the first half of the season in L.A.
Weber's pass picked off. And quickly out of bounds. So that is the end of the first quarter. The West 14-26 from the field. The East only 9-27. Gary Payton leading the way. 3-5 from the field. 7 points and 3 assists. After 1 in Cleveland, it's the West 34. The East 21. We'll be back with more of the 47th All-Star Game after this.
This is the NBA on NBC. The NBA All-Star Game.
Well, among the special moments of this weekend, the All-Star Game halftime celebration. Members of the group selected as the 50 greatest players in NBA history will be introduced. You're seeing many familiar faces, Robert Parrish, the Dr. Julius Erving, so Larry Bird and Willis Reed, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, sitting next to Elgin Baylor, Bill Russell. I would have to say there never has ever been a collection of legendary talent like this assembled in one place at one time.
Marv, it's the most amazing thing that I've ever been involved in. For the first time in 25 years, I am on such a cloud, my legs don't hurt anymore at all.
Wow, you're ready to go. Well, Eddie Jones getting to the line. Nice move by Jones on the reverse, fouled by Glenn Rice.
When Eddie Jones able to get by, he's one of the guys who can create off his own dribble. And again, Mutombo on the bench, not a lot of shot blockers out there for the Eastern Conference.
Second quarter just underway. Here's Rice. Rice off the foul going. John Stockton back on the floor. In the back row, Latrell Sprewell. Here's Sprewell going with the left hand. And rebounded by Brandon, setting the East. Brandon with Hardaway in the backcourt. Baker, Weber, and Rice up front. Brandon eluding Sprewell. And rebounded by Garnett.
Well, Terrell, Brandon did say before the game he was going to be very offensive-minded and shoot the ball a lot. I think he has kept his promise. Every time he's touched it, he has launched.
Jones fouled by Brandon.
Now, Terrell Brandon is so used to playing pick-and-roll basketball. Now he's playing off on the wing as a shooting guard and looking for every shot as his parents in the stand, Charles and Charlotte. Charlotte, the head of NBA Moms. Terrific program for the players around the league where the mothers get together and communicate, available to the players when they come into that city to talk to them. And Terrell was asked if he would ever do that. He says, no, I got my mom. I call her all the time.
But it is an extremely nice gesture because Charlotte Brandon does live in the Portland area, and they've
extended to some of the young players like Jermaine O'Neal of the Portland Trailblazers. That won't count. Foul called before the shot. Gugliotta picked up the foul. Terrell Brandon, who is certainly accustomed to this court and the rims, not shy about popping them up. Five shots in 6-7 minutes of play.
I'm sure he's glancing over at Mike Fratello every single time up and down the court, too. Say, I can play this style as well.
Well, Terrell can. The problem is, can the other Cavaliers? That's the problem. And the Cavaliers in for a very rough second half of the season. Tough schedule with many of the other Eastern teams in that area, 7, 8, 9 the conference. That's favorable schedule.
Garnett with a block to stop Rice, who thought he was fouled. 39-23, the West in front with a minute and a half gone by in the second quarter. Eddie Jones has been the hot man for the West. He has scored the last 7 points for his team. Here's Rice. And again, he's winning. Ben Baker of the Milwaukee Bucks. The West now leading by 14.
Kevin Garnett is really closing down the middle, making it difficult on any penetration.
Gugliotta. And back comes Hardaway. Here's Baker. To the fadeaway. Now Stockton running the floor. Pushes to Gugliotta. And it's tipped home by Jones. Eddie Jones of the Los Angeles Lakers has taken over here in the second quarter. He now has 10 points at all. Eddie Jones averaging 16 per game. 16 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists. As Matt mentioned earlier, leads the league in steals. Stay right here to Jones. Reach and foul.
Well, Vin Baker very active around the basket, and when the shot blockers go up, they are not in good position to do anything else, and Vin Baker takes advantage of it. Very strong around the basket, muscles through, no big men in there to stop him. A terrific job by Tom Gugliotta, not with a lot of blinding speed, but turned it on at midcourt, ran right to the rim, ball delivered on time.
Sonics Lakers, then Magic Bulls, next Sunday on NBC.
He'll give me this shirt. Personally, he says he likes my moves. Penny gave me this shirt because he modeled his game after mine.
Well, Hill and I carpool to work every morning. Penny was going to give me his car, but I wanted the jersey instead.
Hill and I exchanged recipes.
Look under Sprite bottle cap, and you can win free Sprite or authentic Grand Hill or Penny Hardaway jerseys. Then, make up a better story.
Penny's my cousin.
Well, Hill played the guitar as my bar mitzvah.
AT&T can deliver it to you through the internet. AT&T, nobody makes it easier to catch the wave.
Star Game is brought to you by Sprite. Image is nothing. Thirst is everything. Obey your thirst. Sprite. By Plymouth. One clever idea after another. That's Plymouth. And by AT&T.
Well, covering tonight's game and continuing a tradition of 72 years of providing aerial coverage at the nation's top sporting event, the Goodyear blimp from high above Cleveland. What a second quarter it's been for Eddie Jones, who was the most valuable player of the All-Star rookie game some 3 years back in Phoenix, and enjoying this, his first All-Star selection.
And Eddie is not waiting for anything to happen. He is making it happen. The drive on the baseline, and not taking for granted that Gugliotta would make that layup, followed it beautifully.
Matt, Eddie can play that transition game, and the Lakers are putting on quite a show. The athleticism of Eddie Jones today, and Kobe Bryant yesterday, who won the slam dunk contest, and that was magnificent in the rookie All-Star game. 31 points and 8 rebounds, and 13 for 16 free throws for Kobe in the rookie game yesterday.
For the West, Detlef Schrempf of the Seattle Sonics has come on for the first time. John Stockton has 5, and the West increases its lead 44 second quarter. It's Christian Laettner.
Well, the West is just doing a better job of moving the ball, finding the open man, consequently getting a lot of open shots.
So Dumas with the Pistons on the floor for the first time could not handle that low pass. Oh, away from Jones for Schrepp. So Detlef with his first field goal as the West with a 46-25 advantage. Joe Dumars, a late addition due to the injury suffered by Alonzo Mourning. Now Baker posting up, getting deep, and drew the foul. Foul on Gugliotta.
Stockton is so crafty at finding guys. He gives it up early, and then Eddie Jones, the presence to find the finisher, Detlef Schrempf. The best drill in basketball to practice, and the most fun, is a three-on-two conditioner, Marv, which was a drill invented by John Wooden. That's what this game is like, just up and down with the fast break, and the, if you don't get it, just quickly get to the other end.
Well, Matt and I understand that, but we thought it was very unusual that you would run us and the entire crew through that drill prior to tonight's game.
I like the two part where we just stand there. Don't have to move.
The West by 20. Tom Malone is back. He is up front with Schrempf and Gugliotta. Stockton in the backcourt with Jones. Stockton penetrates.
John Stockton.
Mark, so many of these games are games of streaks, though, where a team will get way out and the other team will come back and score 20, 25 points in a row.
Michael Jordan is back on the floor. Again, Baker posting, drawing the double team. Jordan, yes, and it counts. The foul committed by Schrempf, and for Michael Jordan, that is his first field goal.
Now, Michael has a little bit of a look of determination right now. Coming off the bench, I think he's disappointed along with the rest of the Eastern squad with just 26 points up until that point in almost a quarter and a half. So Michael, instead of trying to do something with the ball, working hard without it.
But you love to see the big guys, Ben Baker that time, but nobody's doing it better than... But the big guys passing the ball out of the low post. So Ben Baker, nice in the triple threat position.
Still a very effective yes call. Just kind of slid it in there during the course of conversation. Patted away by Laettner. And here's Dumars, the East showing some sign. Oh, Hill lost his balance. Jordan. Rebounded by Chris Gatling of the Dallas Mavericks. Notice for the first time in All-Star history, the players are wearing their individual team uniforms instead of that generic look. Matumbo saying, don't come back in here.
They did wave the finger a little bit, oddly enough. And he's upset about it. He's been called for a couple of taunting technicals after blocking shots and waving that finger. Don't bring that in here.
Bill, how would you have reacted to that from an opposing player?
Would have grabbed it right back and dunked it in his face.
Exactly. That's the kind of answer we wanted. Here's Gatling. Why did I think you would answer in that matter? Here's Hill. Late to try to rebound on the floor. Shrimp from Malone. And intended for Gatling. Timeout has been called by the East with 6:56 remaining in the first half. The West up by 18 points a moment ago. Michael Jordan on the follow, following the missed free throw, takes it right to the rim. So Michael Jordan with a couple of buckets in the second quarter. The West 48, the East 30. We'll be back with more of the All-Star game in a moment.
With its sleek styling, easy out roller seat.
Do everything, but I could do one thing at a time. And I realized I wasn't the only one out there. I've learned so much from so many different people. It's been great getting involved. Team up with your community.
The most ambitious film ever made for television. A smoldering success. This marathon of thrills isn't in theaters. It's only on NBC. Asteroid, only from Sunday on NBC.
Well, Doug Collins and Rudy Tomjanovich are making their all-star coaching debuts. Both have appeared as players. Collins selected in four straight all-star games, starting in 1977 as a member of the Philadelphia 76ers. And Rudy Tomjanovich, a five-time all-star for the Rockets back in the 1970s. Let's go to Jim Gray with Rudy T.
All right, thank you very much, Marv. Rudy, what are you trying to accomplish here in an all-star game as a coach?
Well, first of all, everybody have fun. Do what you can do best, and everybody get a shot at it.
Is it a tough situation to divide the minutes and to get everybody playing time, keep everybody happy with you?
Yeah, it really isn't easy. In fact, we spent a good amount of time before the game with the assistant coaches trying to divvy it up, and not the easiest thing. You know, even with your own team, when you got eight players, it's pretty tough, but when you got 12 great players, it's harder.
Rudy, do you even really try and coach in a game like this, or you just let them run up and down?
We try to stay out of the way.
Looks like a pretty good opportunity to break your six-game losing streak, huh?
We'll see. I hope so.
How about the second half of the season? Are you concerned? Do you have that six-game losing streak? A couple of your guys are injured, not playing today. Are you concerned as you go here in the second half?
Yeah, of course we're a little concerned, but I felt a little better because I saw Charles Barkley in the locker room today down in a defensive stance sliding, so that makes me feel better.
Rudy, thank you. We'll let you get back to coaching.
All right, thank you.
Marv?
All right, thank you, Jim. Rudy Tomjanovich, in his first all-star coaching appearance, guided the Houston Rockets to back-to-back NBA titles in 1994 and 95.
And Rudy telling me before the game that's the first time he has seen Charles in a defensive stance this year.
Here's two Mars. The West up 51-30. Matt resorting to cheap shots in his first half.
I think Charles is an outstanding defensive force in the NBA. Now, speaking of the coaches, though, everybody's been teasing Doug Collins all week how he's going to manage the minutes to get his guy, Grant Hill, that MVP opportunity. But Jordan has outplayed him by 2 minutes so far as they're both on the floor this minute.
Grant to this point quiet, 2 of 3 from the field. Leitner, Christian Leitner, has had an outstanding season as a member of the Atlanta Hawks, averaging 19 points, 9 rebounds. Air ball from Malone, and then the foul, or deflected out, no foul, deflected out of bounds by Schrepp. Scottie Pippen is back, replacing Joe Dumars.
All of the East squad a little bit leery of Doug Collins, who will forever be known as the kissing bandit after planting one on Terry Mills a couple of weeks ago after he hit a clinching three-point shot right on the lips.
That is, as you well know, these things can happen during the course of an NBA season. And Pippen fires the three. Leitner with the rebound. So the West 53 and the East 34 as we come up on 5 minutes remaining in the first half. Richmond for three. Mitch Richmond with his second from downtown. The West up now 56-34, and Hill is fouled by Schrepp.
Scotty Pippen shoots a long bomb from dead in the corner, often a keeper. Fast break the other way, but nobody gets on Christian Leitner, and he just overpowers his way.
Oh, what a turnaround for Christian Leitner, who was always under siege in Minnesota as the culprit for all the problems they had. He was telling me the other day, he said, we had all these coaching changes. We never really had a solid point guard. And he said, I'm the same guy. I'm the same player. I just happen to be playing on a better basketball team that happens to have a key player like Dikembe Mutombo is going to cover up a lot of mistakes. And, of course, Mookie Blaylock, Steve Smith, having outstanding seasons for letting him come off.
And remember, that was in the early days of the T-Wolves franchise before the stability that McHale brought.
Nice move by Hardaway. Leitner spent 3.5 years with Minnesota, then traded to Atlanta last February in that deal involving Spud Webb and Andrew Lang. 56-38, the West on top. Jordan with the point. And rebounded by Richmond. Gatling. And Gatling.
The West is doing a far superior job of throwing the ball.
Penny Hardaway out in transition once again. I think Penny's the guy that could really step up here. He's been playing so well and has really been overlooked with all the emphasis that's constantly around Jordan and then, of course, Grant Hill. Penny is right there.
Open three for West leading 56-40, and the ball goes back to the West.
Now, the last two times we saw Penny Hardaway try to throw ahead to Michael Jordan, that time Grant Hill, although he's not really in a position to catch and do anything with it.
And Gatling not able to hit. Hardaway pops it down. Here's Hill with Richmond. Hill sweeping in. Grant Hill. So that's his third field goal. He had shot 11 of 18 over his first two All-Star games. He now has 8 points. And it's now a 14-point lead for the West. They had one stretch led by as many as 23. And again, the East on the run. Jordan delivers to Pippen. Able to slice through, and it leads to a timeout call by the West.
Well, one of the best plays for the Eastern squad has been not to get back on defense. And that'll get you open for some breakaway plays. But this one, the defense was set. But Hardaway, nice through the lane, able to use the left hand nicely. Here, never bothered to get back on defense. A little cherry picking, but the East will take it to try to get back into this ballgame.
I detect a correlation to the East surge with Jordan, Pippen, Grant Hill, and Penny Hardaway returning to the lineup.
And it's a 14-3 run by the East. Certainly has helped that the West has missed its last six. Scottie Pippen putting it down on the drive. 3:05 remaining. First half.
Oh, no. Soft leather and burled walnut. And with a 3.5-liter power plant, it should be anything but a Sunday drive in the park. Introducing the Acura RL, the new flagship from Acura.
Pizza Hut employee memo number 11. Even more pepperoni. There are some folks who wish pepperoni was its own food group, so for them, we're going to put an insane amount on our pepperoni lover's pizza.
How many pepperoni pieces?
93 on a large.
93?
93?
93?
93?
93?
Yep. Every large pepperoni lover's pizza now gets 93 slices.
Okay.
Put them under the cheese. Put them over the cheese. If it's pepperoni they want...
I named my dog Peppy. That's how much I like pepperoni.
Pepperoni they'll get. Pizza Hut, making it great again and again.
Next Sunday at the special time of 2:30 Eastern, a big NBA doubleheader on NBC. First, a rematch of that Super Sunday one-point thriller when Kemp and the Sonics battle the LA Lakers. Then, last year's Eastern Conference finalists meet again as Michael and the Bulls host Penny and the Magic. Next Sunday at 2:30 Eastern on NBC. A 14-3 run by the East. The West having its shooting problems the last couple of minutes. Eddie Jones has left the way. He's had a very strong second quarter. We welcome you back to Cleveland. The West leading by as many as 23, now up by 12 points. Good ball movement here by the West. And Richmond by Shrimp with the back tap handle by Leitner. And here comes Hill. Hardaway. Back to Hill. 10-point West lead.
Marv, Penny Hardaway is distributing that ball beautifully and so effortlessly on the money every time. A thing of beauty.
Hey. Well, they missed 8 straight shots. formation on the floor for the East has helped bring them back. Nice move by Jordan. And then pitches out to his teammate, Scottie Pippen. Jordan with a shoulder ball maneuver, but Elisha Watt did not go for it.
2 minutes.
The runner. And a loose ball foul. The West House missed nine consecutive shots. Peyton was called for the foul, his second. I think Michael enjoyed that show the ball maneuver that has worked on many an occasion.
Well, you know, Akeem Olajuwon, one of the best defenders of all time, but he's not going to get caught out on the floor trying to do anything with Michael Jordan. He's going to give him that jump shot all day long and try not to get embarrassed by any means on getting beat on the dribble.
Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, the Chicago Bulls, delighted for Steve Kerr, who won the long-distance shootout with an extraordinary shooting last night. Steve arrived here in Cleveland from the West Coast late. He had trouble making it in time for the required media session, so he called NBA Vice President of Basketball Operations Rod Thorne to tell him, and Rod told Steve, this was last Thursday, don't worry about it, nobody wants to talk to you anyway.
But the electricity in the air while Kerr was putting on that incredible demonstration of shooting is, and the concentration you see in that young man, is fabulous.
They wanted to talk to Steve after that last night. A minute 40 remaining in the first half. Redmond lost it off his foot. Leitner's outlet. It's a 4-on-2, and it's Hill mishandled. And it was very fortunate that a violation was not called. As much as Christian Leitner disliked playing center, Jordan in the middle. Right in the face of Sean Kemp. So the East is now within seven.
Leitner's doing a good job holding down the middle. Helps if you got Jordan, Grant Hill, and Penny and Glenn Rice.
On a 19-3 run by the East, and they keep coming. One time it was a 23-point ball, just under 1 minute left in the first half. Draws the foul. Foul on Christian Leitner.
Jordan's starting to take over. When you can score on Sean Kemp in the low post, there's nothing better than busting the big guys. And then Penny with the layup and Jordan over the top. One time down the court, you face up Sean Kemp and a turnaround post up, and then you tip over Akeem. He's pretty good.
Fine observation, Bill. Michael Jordan now 9 points, 6 assists, 7 rebounds. 20-second timeout has been called. Well, right here, let's take a look ahead to a much anticipated NBC show next Sunday. It's the biggest action-packed disaster of February, and it hits home next Sunday. Don't miss a minute of the action. That's Asteroid next Sunday right here on NBC. Doug Collins talking to his squad. Doug, who has done a sensational job bringing the Pistons to the third best record in the East. Chicago owning the best record in the Eastern Conference, but Phil Jackson coached the All-Stars last season. NBA rules do not allow back-to-back appearances as head coach. And a reminder, coming up at halftime, the 50 greatest players will be introduced. Should be some emotional moments on the court here. Bill Walton among the 50. And I know you are excited about that introduction.
A lot of great things in my life have happened, Mark, but nothing, absolutely nothing, has topped this.
And a hacking foul. It is on Richmond. We're down to 42 seconds left in the first half. You're talking about working this telecast? Are you talking about
both, Mark. It got so special yesterday that Bill Russell was even signing everybody's autograph.
You're kidding.
Absolutely not. Bill was in there smiling and laughing and going around signing everybody's books.
You may receive a bill in about 11. Sweeping through. And the West now leads by only four.
How about
caught the smile on Michael's face. He said, I haven't done that in about 7 years. The old launching pad on the missed free throw.
Nice box out. And the East will get it back. The West has missed its last 10 shots. They led at one point 53-30. They were up by 23. Here's Hardaway for three. Yes! The West by only one. And they're hoping for a final possession of this first half.
Now, the West has had no answers for the versatile lineup of the East. They have beaten them in every area.
Elijah Wan with a beautiful move. So the West finally able to hit. It's a 27-7 run. Final seconds of the first half, and Jordan was looking to throw to his right. Looked like he wanted to give it up. It was batted out of bounds. Last touch by the West. Right now, only 0.2 seconds showing on the clock.
And nobody's walking over there to take it out of bounds. Lobbed a penny at the hoop right here.
Yeah, this will need a deflection to count. And here it is. Did he get it all in time? He caught it, said Hugh Evans. Would not have counted. Was not a tip. Must be a tip. So, a very entertaining first half in this 47th NBA All-Star game. The West by three at halftime.
Well, normally when you play the Chicago Bulls, you warn your team about Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan doing this on missed free throws, and usually everybody's in position to stop it. Here in All-Star competition, nobody even expected it, and there goes Michael. Actually, Mitch Richmond tried to grab on and hold, but Michael just whipped around him.
And Michael Jordan, 12 points, 9 rebounds, 6 assists. Grant Hill with 11. They led the surge in the second quarter. Eddie Jones with 10 points for the West. Gary Payton with 9. But the story in the final minutes of the second quarter, the combination of Jordan Hill and Hardaway, and Michael Jordan enjoying the moment. Stay tuned for the Prudential Halftime Report that's coming up shortly, and we'll also be able to watch the introduction of the 50 greatest players of all time. But right now, let's go to Ahmad Rashad with Grant Hill. Ahmad?
But listen, Grant, you're all over the floor. You when you're playing a game like this, you want to win it. And you guys really came on strong in the second quarter.
Yeah, you know, the West team came out with a little bit more energy. And, you know, in the second quarter, Doug just said, hey, let's go out there and give it all we got. And they got Michael out there, and he got us going. And I think we're down 3 now, so now it's a ball game.
Could you try to stand up a little bit longer? You've been on the floor quite a bit.
Yeah, I've been falling. I got knee bruises all over the place. I'm falling all over the place. I'm the dirty man. I'm the Kurt Rambis.
But now, how important to play in an All-Star game like this with all these 50 great players in attendance?
It's tough. A little pressure. You know, one, being here on national television, being in an All-Star game, but then you got guys you idolize all your life in attendance here, and get a little nervous. But I think once you get through those nerves, go out there and play basketball, have fun.
All right, I look forward to a strong second half.
So do I. I hope so.
All right, thanks, Grant. Back to you, Marv.
All right, Ahmad, and coming up in a moment, Bob Costas with the Prudential Halftime Report. That's right after these messages.
Good morning.
I'd like to cash in my miles for one ticket to Paris, France.
I'm sorry, sir. Your miles have expired.
I've been charging on my Visa card for years to earn this trip, and now I'm going to have to pay for the ticket. It happened. Paris.
Visa says you're over your limit.
Visa, everywhere you want to be. Oh, Paris, have I told you what I've been through? I need a doctor. Je suis un espion.
Espion?
Espion! But Visa, can you at least help me find a doctor? How about a lawyer?
Visa says they're everywhere, but American Express helps you with just about everything. So you can always do more.
I do not get French fashion.
Thank you.
the level of North Carolina, be realistic.
Forget the team. Think of yourself. Why go back to basketball? You'll embarrass yourself.
Had enough?
Just getting started.
Wednesday, a new landlord joins the cast of Chicago Sun. Hey, he looks familiar.
Sorry, guys. I'm raising the rent.
Scottie Pippen's raising our rent! Yeah!
All new Chicago Suns, NBC, Wednesday.
This is the Prudential Halftime Report, brought to you by Prudential. Bringing strength and stability to America's families through insurance, healthcare, real estate, and financial services.
Time of the NBA All-Star Game in Cleveland, with the Western Conference leading the East 60-57. A 23-point deficit has been whittled down to three. Well, they just finished playing the duet by way of technology between Nat and Natalie Cole, Unforgettable, and some unforgettable moments are being relived here in Cleveland as they celebrate the 50th anniversary of the league. 49 of the 50 players selected as the league's greatest are alive. Only Pete Maravich has passed away. 47 of the 50 are here. Shaquille O'Neal hurt and back in Los Angeles. Jerry West, who would be on the short list of the greatest players ever, undergoing surgery. He's missed here this weekend, but 47 of the 50 are here. And now we turn it over to the public address announcer at Gund Arena, Jeff Shreve, to meet those 47 all-time greats. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the court and welcome the 50 greatest NBA players of all time. Meet the 50 greatest players in NBA history. Here are the guards. From the Chicago Bulls, number 23, Michael Jordan. From the Utah Jazz, number 12, John Stockton. From the Houston Rockets, number 22, Clyde the Clyde Drexler. From the Detroit Pistons, number 11, Isaiah Thomas. From the Los Angeles Lakers, number 32, Irvin Magic Johnson. From the San Antonio Spurs, number 44, the Iceman, George Gervin. Represented by his two sons, Joshua and Jason. From the New Orleans Jazz, number 7, Pistol Pete Maravich. From the Boston Celtics, number 7, Nate Tiny Archibald. From the New York Knicks, number 10, Walt Clyde Frazier. From the Baltimore Bullets, number 10, Earl the Pearl Monroe. From the Detroit Pistons, number 21, Dave Bing. From the Milwaukee Bucks, number 1, the Big O, Oscar Robertson. Unable to be here is number 44 from the Los Angeles Lakers, Mr. Clutch, Jerry West. From the St. Louis Hawks, number 19, Lenny Wilkins.
from the Philadelphia 76ers, number 15, Hal Greer. From the Boston Celtics, number 24, Sam Jones. From the Boston Celtics, number 14, Bob Cousy. From the Boston Celtics, number 21, Bill Sharman. Ladies and gentlemen, the guards. And now here are the forwards. From the Chicago Bulls, number 33, Scottie Pippen. Originally from the Philadelphia 76ers, number 34, Charles Barkley. From the Utah Jazz, number 32, the mailman, Carl Malone. From the Los Angeles Lakers, number 42, James Worthy. From the Boston Celtics, number 32, Kevin McHale. From the Boston Celtics, number 33, Larry Bird. From the Philadelphia 76ers, number 6, Dr. J. Julius Erving. From the Washington Bullets, number 11, the Big E. Philadelphia 76ers, number 32, the Kangaroo Kid, Billy Cunningham. From the Golden State Warriors, number 24, Rick Barry. From the New York Knicks, number 32, Jerry Lucas. From the New York Knicks, number 22, Dave DeBuscher. From the Boston Celtics, number 17, John Hondo Havlicek. From the Los Angeles Lakers, number 22, Elgin Baylor. From the St. Louis Hawks, number 9, Bob Pettit. From the Syracuse Nationals, number 4, Dalton. Paul Arizin. Ladies and gentlemen, the forward. And now here they are, the centers. Unable to be here from the Los Angeles Lakers, number 34, Shaquille O'Neal. From the San Antonio Spurs, number 50, the Admiral, David Robinson. From the New York Knicks, number 33, Patrick Ewing. From the Houston Rockets, number 34, Hakeem the Dream Olajuwon. A former member of the Boston Celtics, number 00, the Chief, Robert Parrish. From the Philadelphia 76ers, number 2, Moses Malone. From the Portland Trailblazers, number 32, Bill Walton. From the Boston Celtics, number 18, Dave Cowens. From the Los Angeles Lakers, number 33, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. From the Washington Bullets, number 41, Wes Unseld. From the New York Knicks, number 19, Willis Reed. From the San Francisco Warriors, number 42, Nate Thurman. From the Los Angeles Lakers, number 13, Wilt Chamberlain. From the Boston Celtics, number 6, Bill Russell. From the Minneapolis Lakers, number 99, George Mikan. The centers. Ladies and gentlemen, let us salute together the greatest NBA players of all time.
For the second half. The West leads by 3. Back to Marv, Matt, and Bill after these messages from your local station.
In Cleveland, the West with a 60-57 lead on the East in this 47th NBA All-Star game. The West at one point led by as many as 23, but a 27-7 run to end the half led by Michael Jordan, Grant Hill, and Penny Hardaway turns it into a three-point game. What a stirring scene at halftime with the 50 greatest players of all time honored just moments ago. Our partner Bill Walton will be rejoining us shortly. But Matt, as you looked out at the 50 greatest, I know there are a number of memories that hit home.
Tremendous memories, tremendous thrill to see those players all honored that way. And a special feeling for me because I played with some of them. Will Chamberlain, Hal Greer, Billy Cunningham, Tiny Archibald. I was coached by Bob Cousy, and fortunate enough, I was able to coach Julius Erving, Charles Barkley, and Moses Malone. So I feel a little part of it.
It was a real kick just to see that group assembled here at halftime. Let's check out the Miller Lite halftime statistics. The West missing 10 of their last 11 shots, and this group led the East back into it. Michael Jordan with 12 points in all, Grant Hill with 11, and Penny Hardaway had 11. Michael started slowly and then came on from all angles.
Well, Michael, not feeling the jump shot, decided to do everything around the basket, including that spectacular follow-up after the missed free throw. And that's 5 for 11 from the field. Michael will still try to test that jumper, I'm sure, in that second half.
And a look at the West. They have their shooting problems in the final minutes of the second quarter. Eddie Jones of the Los Angeles Lakers had the hot hand. 3 of 3 from the field, and then 4 from the line for his 10 points. 3-point field goals. Well, it was 7 of 15 shooting for the West, only 1 of 8. For the East. And Jordan, along with his scoring, did it with 9 rebounds and 6 assists. 3-point lead for the West as we head to the second half. We'll be back at the Gund Arena in a moment.
Welcome back to Cleveland. I'm Jim Gray. I'm now joined by one of the greats, one of the 50 greats, Earl the Pearl Monroe. You went in with the bullets. Earl, just how emotional was that for you guys up there?
Well, I'll tell you, I don't think any one of us expected this type of turnout, the type of hoopla and whatnot that was generated out here. We see it on TV, but we don't expect it to happen to us, and it was really very wonderful.
And you truly felt it. You got a little choked up. Some of the guys did as well, didn't they?
Yeah, I think so, because, you know, for all intents and purposes, you know, this might be our last hurrah out here. And we came out, and being with these guys for the whole weekend has been very special. We don't get together that often, and when we do get together, it seems like old times.
Talk about the camaraderie. There were a lot of guys signing books, a lot of guys having a lot of laughs, wasn't it?
Yes, you know, and it's so strange because, you know, you don't like to get autographs, but there was everybody with books signing back and forth and whatnot. I think we all enjoyed it, and, you know, we wouldn't miss this for the world.
Earl, congratulations.
Well, I appreciate it. It's nice to be here.
All right, let's send it across the way now to Ahmad Rashad.
All right, thanks, Jim. You know, there was a lot of there was a lot of emotion back there, but out here you see they're playing around. But back in the back when they had the 50 greatest back there, these guys were having the time of their life. I mean, tears were almost coming to Julius Irving's eyes. I'm sure he'll try to say it wasn't, but I saw him. Now, in the game, you see that Michael Jordan is wearing a Pip wristband. And I talked to Scottie Pippen about that, and he said, you know, I think Michael might make a very good spokesman for this product. So that's how he got Michael to wear
that. Hey, Pops, how you doing? Just want to say hello to my father back in Cambridge. I know he's watching it. All right.
And Patrick, all the players have told Patrick he should probably have a ticket and sit up in the stands, but he is sitting on the bench. Let's go back over to you, Marv.
Dangerous area for Ahmad Rashad to be working. As the West and the East have just completed their warm-ups, and we're just about ready for the start of play in the second half. Michael Jordan, with his numbers, 5 of 11, 12 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 assists, is closing in on a triple-double. There never has been a triple-double in the history of all-star competition. In 1984 in Denver, Magic Johnson, 15 points, 22 assists, 9 rebounds. That about the closest. A look at some of the Jordan highlights from the second quarter. Doing it from all angles. Of the free throw. So Michael Jordan lighting it up to help get the East back into it.
I think getting behind by 23 points in the first and second quarter really got Michael fired up. He never wants to be embarrassed in any situation, and he is certainly one guy who can do something about it.
6 assists, 4 away from that elusive triple-double.
I'd keep shooting if I were him.
And we are rejoined by Bill Walton as we refuse to take off the NBA's 50th anniversary jacket as Kemp opens up this third quarter by launching one.
Mark, it's never coming on until I get home and I present it to my dad.
And Vin Baker. Fourth field goal for Vin Baker, one of the outstanding power forwards from the Milwaukee Bucks. 60-59 the score. Karl Malone. Team Olajuwon, Sean Kemp up front, Gary Payton, John Stockton in the backcourt for the West. Baker getting to that loose ball. Terrell Brandon starting the second. Nice feed for Baker. And the East has taken the lead. They're up now 61-60. First time they have led since the opening minutes when it was 2-0.
Whose decision was it to bench Jordan?
As Terrell Brandon, who said he was going to shoot the ball every time he touched it, couldn't resist finding a wide open Vin Baker. But what Doug is really trying to do is divvy up the minutes a little bit. These guys did not get the amount of minutes that the others did in that first half. He wants to even it up. And then if it's a close game in the fourth quarter, he's going to go with the 5 guys he thinks can win it.
And Michael standing out there during halftime. One of the 50 greatest, as you just mentioned, that was tiring to him.
Maybe it was a disciplinary matter for not listening to the halftime speech.
Lamb Rice with a 3-pointer, and it's the East with its biggest lead of the game. They were down by as many as 23. They're now up by 4 points. Malone with the fake. And Malone coming up the short. Brandon with Pippen and Rice on the wings. Open shot for one of the best. Glenn Rice.
Well, Glenn told me this morning that he is in the greatest shooting rhythm of his life. The hoop looks as big as the backboard. Everything he throws up, nothing but net.
And he has been on a tear for the last month, averaging 30-something. And the reason why is he was looking at tapes of their games early in the year, and he felt he was not aggressive. And what really clinched it was his fiance told him, said, hey, you think you're playing out there? You aren't doing a thing. And he has gone on a tear ever since. And the happiest guy in the world is Dave Cowens for the way that he is playing. And the East squad, who knows, who have been watching Glenn Rice fill it up lately, know that he is hot.
Glenn Rice averaging 25 a game for the Charlotte Hornets. That's the number 5 man in scoring.
in the NBA, plays 42 minutes a game, and that is second in the league to his teammate Anthony Mason.
It's remarkable what they've done in Charlotte with Cowens, Anthony Mason, and Glenn Rice leading the way. They've brought that spirit back to that franchise that was rocked by a couple of giveaways.
7-point lead for the East. They are on a 37-7 run the last 8 minutes. Rice. That is his third consecutive from downtown. He was one for his previous seven. Gary Payton right back. So it's the East 70 and the West 62.
Well, nobody stepped up offensively for the West Conference.
And the foul is called. Rice shows the entire repertoire, taking it to the basket.
Very difficult matchup for the West big forwards, both Sean Kemp and Karl Malone, who are not yet on the same page starting this third quarter. Neither one of them knows who they're guarding, and you just can't leave Glenn Rice that open.
Foul on Stockton, non-shooting call. Open shot for Brandon. From downtown, it is a different story here in the third quarter. And now Brandon wants to run. Pippen. Well, Baker try to slam it home, try to one-time it, as they say in the National Hockey League.
In the history of basketball, John Stockton got thieves by Jarrell Brandon beautifully.
Christian Laettner playing a lot center today and doing it very well.
Reach-in foul. Foul on Laettner.
That's a simple game. Shoot when you're open, which is what Glenn Rice has been doing, and pass when you're not, unselfishly giving up the ball to the wide-open Jarrell Brandon.
The forwards for the West are getting killed because they're used to playing the bang-up game down low, Kemp and Karl Malone. And then the strip there by Terrell Brandon, voted this week by some as the best point guard in the NBA.
Well, Sports Illustrated magazine had Brandon on the cover, and he was anointed as the top point guard in the league.
I didn't know Sports Illustrated was having such trouble getting tickets here in Cleveland.
And Phil taking a shot. Glenn Rice is 4 of 4 from downtown, 5 for 5. Overall, 4 of 4 from three-point range in this third quarter. Here's Brandon. Rice again.
Are we watching the long-distance shootout contest within the framework of the game?
78-63, the East up.
Beautiful move by Stockton.
You know, Bob, even in All-Star games, matchups are important, and even though Malone and Kemp are the starters and starting the third quarter, they just can't find Glenn Rice. It's just not in their makeup to go play a guy on the perimeter that can shoot the ball as well as Glenn Rice.
7:20 left in the third quarter. Nice fake. And a series of fakes by Hakeem Olajuwon. The East has outscored the West 21-7 here in the third quarter.
Obviously, Eating agrees with Hakeem. That shot, so difficult. Behind the board, gave up the layup to come with the spin-around jump hook.
Laettner. Rebounded by Baker. Baker's done a nice job. He now has 13 points. The East 80. The West 67. Overall, the East leads the series at All-Star Competition 29-17. They have split the last 10 games. The East has won 2 of the last 3. Here's Stockton.
Yes.
For John Stockton.
Well, Gary Payton is really looking to pass that ball. He's a marvelous playmaker, but with the West struggling offensively, as strong a finisher as he needs to get to the hoop a little bit more.
To Payton, who was in a very difficult position, out of bounds. So the ball back to to the East, but first a timeout is called with 6:11 remaining in the third.
Well, John Stockton trying to make things happen, had his head up all the way. Actually, I thought he wanted to pass the ball on that play, but left open for the shot. And this is embarrassing for Christian Laettner, who's already beaten once, and Akeem goes back the other way. Say, hey, just beat me with the first move. Don't embarrass me.
And then Stockton left wide open along the baseline. Gary Payton unselfishly giving it up. John Stockton delivering. So the East by 10. They had trailed by as many as 23.
Game is brought to you by Budweiser. Beechwood aged for a crisp, clean, classic taste. By Nissan, who reminds you that life is a journey. Enjoy the ride. And by Microsoft Software. Where do you want to go today?
Well, based just 30 miles from Gund Arena, the Goodyear blimp, Spirit of Akron, giving us that exterior, very high shot from above the Gund Arena. All-Star Weekend in Cleveland, and indoors, 1,500 media credentials issued for the weekend. In fact, the number of international media members covering this year's All-Star Game will actually be greater than the number of American media members at the 1981 All-Star Game, the last time that Cleveland played host to the All-Star Extravaganza. Close to 300 international media members are on hand here tonight. We are delighted to be with you, Marv Albert, with Pat Dukas, Bill Walton, Rashad, Jim Gray, Bob Costas handling the hosting duties. Here's Terrell Brandon with the shot clock running down. 80-70 the score. The East with a 10-point lead. The story in this third quarter, Glenn Rice, 12 of his 14 here in the 30s, hit 4 3-pointers. Akeem Olajuwon. So Akeem with 11.
And Rudy Tomjanovich has come with Eddie Jones to try to cool off Glenn Rice if he can. It's a tough shot once a guy is that hot.
Glenn Rice was saying that he's not satisfied with just one time in the All-Star game, which was last year. He says he sees these guys who are here every single year. That's the level he wants to get to. That's his dream. He's living it right now.
Ben Baker has 15 points, the East by 10, and a West turnover. And Terrell Brandon has played marvelous basketball. 7 points, 6 assists, a number of steals, has not turned the ball over. John Stockton and Mitch Richmond, Eddie Jones in a three-guard setup, deflected out by the East. Up front with Akeem Olajuwon, here's Tim Hardaway of the Miami Heat. For Terrell Brandon, who hears it from the crowd. As you mentioned, 7 points, 6 assists. And Grant Hill checking back in, instrumental in that East run of the second quarter. Scottie Pippen departing with 4 points. Olajuwon now played by Weber. Just under 5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. East with the ball. They lead by 10. Rice in a battle with Jones. Excellent interior post passing by Chris Weber that time. Eddie Jones, who was marvelous in the first half and is really one of the game's best defensive players, just outmatched. It's an extremely tough matchup for the West trying to guard Rice. And Weber able to handle that rebound. Now, Bill, this is not a statement as Dave Cowens enjoying the moments as he watches his guy, Glenn Rice. This is not a statement against big men like yourself, and there are still several here in the game. Well, because I'm labeling them. Foul is called. Foul on Jones.
And Glenn Rice wants to show that he is not just a perimeter shooter, that he has improved his post game as Eddie Jones was hung out to dry on the front there. And here running the break has been Chris Weber, who can pass the ball, delivers that one right on time.
Okay, Marv, let's hear the big man.
Well, with some of the key big men not in action today because of injuries, Patrick Ewing of the Knicks, Alonzo Mourning of Miami. Charles Barkley is a large force, but not one of the big men. Shaquille O'Neal of
David Robinson.
Right, David Robinson. He wasn't. Well,
but he would be here.
All right.
But the game has opened up. Obviously, we'd rather see some of those guys here, but we're having, I think, one of the more attractive All-Star games in years, and the reason is that guys are able to flow a little bit more, and there's more room, obviously, to drive the lane, and I think that has added to what is taking place here. Nice move.
I couldn't agree more, Marv, which is why so many of the big men don't play well in these games. It's up and down. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, 6 MVPs in the regular season, never won the MVP of the All-Star game, the only award he did not win. Grant Hill, terrific defense.
Kemp got the step, but had it broken up about 5 on the 24-second line.
Martin, you trying to say it's a better game when the big fellas aren't in there clogging things up in the middle?
At times. Glenn Rice with 18 points in this third quarter. Sean Kemp. That's only his second field goal. 18 points in the quarter for Rice. 18 of his 20 is an all-star record. A check that he's one shy of an all-star record for most points in a single quarter.
Well, back to your big man diatribe. I just like to say that that's why my favorite big men are the ones who are the versatile skilled ones, the guys that can step away from the basket, that can pass the ball, shoot the jumper. Not just the big galoots who stand underneath the basket and try to throw down slam dunk.
Those big galoots. The record for most points in a quarter in All-Star play, 1968. Hal Greer of Matt Dukas' 76ers with 19 points in a single quarter, and Rice with 18, so one away. 2:08 to go in the third. It's the East by 13 over the West. We'll be back with more from the Gund Arena in Cleveland in a moment.
Welcome back to Cleveland. I'm Jim Gray. I'm now joined by Gordon Gund. He is the owner of the Cleveland Cavaliers. He's also the founder of the Foundation Fighting Blindness. For those of you who are unaware, Mr. Gund went blind about 30 years ago. He suffers from a disease, retinitis pigmentosa. Gordon, you're enjoying the game here today, and you enjoyed basketball for a number of years. What's in your mind's eye today as you see the 50, or you're able to visualize the 50 who were out there as well as Michael Jordan?
Well, I've got some remembrance of the earlier 50 because I could see those, but Michael Jordan, I always think of this whirling motion and balance and acrobat with a tongue hanging out and a smile on his face, and he's always knows just what he's doing. He's a wonderful human being, too. He's just a great guy. Of the earlier ones, I do remember people like Bill Russell and Oscar Robertson and Wilt Chamberlain, a number of them.
Now, you still come to all the games, and you are aided. You're able to hear the telecast or the broadcast locally with your earpiece, but you come to all the games, and is it difficult to be here, or have you gotten quite used to it?
Well, I come to some of the games. A lot. I hear them all on the radio, and either here in the building or at home, but it's... No, I get a good picture painted by Joe Tate, our radio announcer. He does just a terrific job.
Do you feel the same type of emotions? You get excited and happy and down when you lose?
Of course, I get very down when we lose. Nobody likes to lose. Sure, I'd love to hear the team working well and as a team and as a unit, and talk with the coaches about it, hear what their strategies are.
It's all part of it.
Gordon, congratulations to you and your wife, Luli, and your brother. It's quite a tribute to you and your family that the game has come here to Cleveland.
Thank you. Well, it's been tremendously exciting for us. Thanks very much, Jim.
All right. Gordon got quite an inspiration to all of us. Marv?
Thank you, Jim. Remarkable man, Gordon Gund, the owner of the Cleveland Cavaliers. We come up on a minute left in the third quarter. Hardaway with a three. And the East now leads 95-82. A moment ago, Glenn Rice did make it 20 points in the third quarter. That is a new All-Star game record, passing by Hal Greer, who in 1968, there's Hal, one of the 50 greatest players of all time. Hal Greer had 19 in a quarter, and Glenn Rice is also online for most points in a half. The record is held by Wilt Chamberlain, and he will take this very badly. 23 and a half, and Tom Chambers did it in 87. Here is the bucket by Rice that gave him 20 points for the half. What a performance by Glenn Rice. That's just his 20 in the third quarter, and he is in line to set set the all-time record for a half. Three away from Chamberlain and Chambers. 40 seconds left in the third. And a loose ball foul is called. It is on Baker. Let's go over to Ahmad Rashad. Ahmad just had a conversation with Glenn Rice. Ahmad?
Well, Marv, you know, a lot of times it's hard to break a record if you don't know anything about it. So I thought that it was, you know, up to me to walk over and tell Glenn, and he was only 1 point away from the record of scoring points in a quarter. So what I'm going to do now is tell him that you 23 points, see, is the record for most points in a half. You just broke the most points in a quarter, so you need just a few more. Can you handle that, right?
I can handle that.
Okay. All right. Back to you, Marv.
Marv, I want you to be the guy to go tell Wilt that he's no longer the record book, and then at the same moment tell Wilt that Michael Jordan, where he ranks of all right. the players, okay? But Wilt will tell you that he had 24 rebounds in that same game. We're down to 38 seconds remaining in the third quarter, and the East now leads 95-84. Once again, the Dean showing his major influence on the game as it is being played. Or, to put it another way, annoying the players. Richmond for three. Back tap by Hill. Here's Jones for three. The Hardaway with Baker on the wing. Oh, and Hardaway with a scoop shot with 11 seconds to go in the third quarter. The East now leads by 12. Here's Gugliotta. Sean Kemp. Kemp with 10. Final seconds of the quarter. East by 10. And here's Hardaway as time has run out in the third. So Glenn Rice with an all-star game record, 20 points in the third quarter. The East outscoring the West in the third, 40-27. We'll be back after these words from your local station.
Ahmad Rashad back at Gund Arena here in Cleveland. And just moments ago, Glenn Rice just broke the quarter record.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, and you look back, and Hal Greer held it, right?
Right.
And this is Wilt Chamberlain, who looked back and said, sorry about that, Hal. Well, now, do you know that the other record is most points in a half is 23, held by you?
Yeah, you mean that's going to go to you, think?
I'm just trying to tell you that.
Oh, well, I can do something about that. It hasn't gone yet, though, right?
No, not yet.
Well, I can do something about that. Even if I have to go back and put on some sneakers.
Uh-oh. You heard it here first. Maybe a comeback. Mom?
All right, thank you, Ahmad. Wilt knows that he's in trouble.
Well, threatening Doug Collins might help to yank Glenn Rice out of the lineup.
Well, there is the rundown. Most points in a half. The record shared by Wilt Chamberlain and Tom Chambers. Here's Glenn Rice, who scored 20 of his 22 points in the third quarter. So three away from tying the record of Wilt Chamberlain and Tom Chambers. Nice backdoor lead, but Matumbo could not put it down. As this fourth quarter gets underway, the East with a 97-87 lead. Mitch Richmond got the step and then whipped it out. Here's Latrell Sprewell coming up short on the three-pointer. The East squad with Penny Hardaway, Joe Dumars, and Michael Jordan in a three-guard setup with Dikembe Mutombo and Chris Webber. Webber on a spin and then lost the grip. Webber recovers. Dumars. Yes. A three.
It looks like Michael Jordan content right now to just sort of run the club, set guys up. He knows he has plenty of shooters out there to dropping back defensively.
And Trapp's pass off the mark. Here comes Jordan. Michael Jordan with a change of direction and swept it to Chris Webber. Jordan. All the way back to Jordan.
Give it to him again. Joe Dumars has had a superb season, rejuvenated with the Detroit Pistons. Kind of stepped aside last season, looking to get Allen Houston into the offense, and he has reemerged as a force, fires the three, and again it comes to the East.
least as Hardaway kept it alive. Here's Mutombo with a side move.
Is that what you were talking about, Marv?
Yes. Foul on Gugliotta. Well, for the past several weeks, online, our own Bill Walton has analyzed his greatest players of all time, and this week, we announced the complete results of who you, the fans, voted as the greatest of all time. Plus, Steve Snapper Jones providing a mid-season NBA report card, and Steve will give us his analysis of this year's rookie classes, all at NBC.com/sports. And I'm told the voting for centers, Kareem with 70% of the vote, Hakeem Olajuwon 22%, Bill Russell at 5%, and Wilt Chamberlain at 3%.
You be sure and give Wilt that news, okay?
We ought to send a mod back to Wilt to inform him of that, Paul, but I have a feeling that the participants, as they say, skew young and may not have seen Russell and Chamberlain. Two on one, Shrimp puts it up for Sprewell. And lays it in.
Almost a 3-second violation as they were patty kicking with the basketball there. As the Penny Hardaway not looking at Joe Dumars in that last possession, caught one right in the chops.
The East leading 101-89. 9.5 remaining in the fourth quarter. Hardaway. Penny Hardaway to the reverse. He has 13 points, and the East up now 103-89 before a capacity crowd of 20,592 have begun to increase. And a timeout is called. Loose ball foul was also called on Hardaway. We have 9:14 left now in the fourth quarter. Here's that reverse by Penny Hardaway. The East 103, the West 89.
Miller Genuine Draft presents a classic moment of the NBA at 50.
Tonight we look back at the first NBA All-Star game. The year was 1951. The site, the old Boston Garden. A pair of Celtics, Bob Cousy and Easy Ed McCauley, led the East to a 111-94 victory. McCauley with 20 points. He was named the game's most valuable player. The leading scorer, Alex Groza of the old Indianapolis Olympians with 17. See 13 for Bobby Davies, George Mikan with 12. There's Dolph Shays behind old number 99, George Mikan. In recognition of this classic moment, Miller Beer will donate $1,000 to the Thurgood Marshall Scholarship Fund. 3 minutes in, fourth quarter. Marv Albert with Bill Walton and Matt Dukas. And Kevin Garnett back on the floor, showing the outside touch for Kevin in his second year with the Minnesota Timberwolves. That is his first All-Star field goal.
Marv, Kevin is one of those guys who can do it all and continues to grow. So very young. You're looking at a guy who's going to be here every year now for the next 15 or 20 years. And as that Timberwolves franchise continues to mature and excel, watch out.
And Gugliotta now with 9 points. The East 103, the West 93. At 1 point in the first half, the West led by as many as 23. The East took over in the second quarter, led by Jordan, Hill, and Hardaway. And then Rice picked up in the third. And the West trying to make a comeback. Here's Payton. Payton taking all the way. Changed his mind. Could not be handled by Sprewell. Back comes Hardaway. There's Dumars for three. The save by Hardaway.
Gary Payton really looking to pass that ball. So reminiscent of the year Mitch Richmond got the MVP when Gary Payton had, I think, 18 or 19 assists in that game.
Pass intended for Jordan. That's on the way. Broken up. And the foul is called. It is on Leitner. Well, next Sunday, join NBC Sports for an NBA doubleheader, starting with NBA Showtime at 2:30 Eastern. In Game 1, a Western Conference contest. The Seattle Supersonics and the Los Angeles Lakers starting at 3 o'clock Eastern Time. And then Penny Hardaway and the Orlando Magic traveling to the Windy City to face Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls. The Bulls at 42-6 at the All-Star break. Must-see TV NBA style next Sunday right here on NBC. Orlando with 5 straight wins and a record of 24-20. Now in third in the Atlanta.
Of course, Dennis Rodman will be back, and Orlando continues to surge on behind the improving play all the time of Penny Hardaway, cycling, killing people out there. And the Lakers playing the best basketball right now in the Western Conference.
Hardaway now with 16 points. The East 106-95 over the West. Here's Matumbo. Is a 9-point East lead. 7 assists for Gary Payton.
Marv, do you practice those lob passes yourself when you're working on your game coming down on the break?
I actually do. I try to bang them high off the glass to myself. Foul on Sprewell.
Gary Payton loves to throw the lob pass. He usually throws it to his teammate, Sean Kemp, but Latrell Sprewell has the hops in those legs as he gets way up there. Timed beautifully between Gary Payton and Latrell Sprewell.
6.5 remaining in the fourth quarter. And the East now leading 106-97.
All-Star Game is brought to you by Nike, who encourages you to participate in the lives of America's youth. By Toyota and their full line of trucks. Toyota trucks always come through. And by Miller Genuine Draft, who reminds you it's time for a good old macro brew.
Well, the aerial shots this evening being provided by the Goodyear blimp, Spirit of Akron. We welcome you back to Cleveland. A look at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I'm spending hours, I myself, looking for Jay Black and the Americans. Not there. There's so much to do on All-Star Weekend. And here in Cleveland, the jam session has provided a terrific time for everyone, boys and girls, testing their basketball skills. Rebecca Lobo providing some tips. The NBA All-Star Weekend, a lot of fun for people of all ages. Well, we did spend much time at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Beautiful celebration here. The city of Cleveland, the Cavaliers themselves, has done a perfect job of hosting this celebration of the ground of the sport of basketball.
Oh, Michael Jordan with that hard drive off the spin, and he was fouled by Chris Gatling. That'll send Jordan to the line.
I'm sure Michael Jordan is aware that he is just 2 assists shy of a triple-double. He's not thinking pass on this play. And he just went right down Broadway with almost no resistance.
You say you know he's aware? Are you you have a feeling that
Ahmad is up to some chicanery over there.
Well, he is 2 assists away from a triple-double. There has never been a triple-double in the history of All-Star play. So Michael Jordan with 14 points, 10 rebounds, and 8 assists. Oscar Robertson, Magic Johnson were both 1 assist away from a triple-double in previous All-Star. Oh, Jordan called for the hard foul on Garnett.
Mark, at the All-Star shoot-around yesterday, the practice session, Garnett and Sean Kemp were putting on a slam dunk exhibition for the fans. That was a thing of beauty. They were looking down at the rim.
Kevin Garnett is the second youngest to ever play in an All-Star game. Magic Johnson, the youngest by 3 months.
Bill, you mentioned earlier that Kevin is still growing, literally. He's actually 7 feet, but his coach, Flip Saunders, just says he's 6'12", because Kevin, at this point in his career, does not want to be a center, although other teams are guarding him with the center. And, of course, in this game, he has played some of the center position, but he may just reinvent the so-called small forward position because he has all of those types of skills, being able to shoot from the perimeter, handle the ball, and pass.
wonderfully agreeable young man. Did he agree to do something for you? Is that
Leitner with the bucket and the foul? So Christian Leitner will go to the line.
Kevin Garnett, first win up to Minnesota. And Kevin McHale, who runs the operation up there, was showing him around and said, well, you know, here's the equipment room and whatever you would like. And Kevin said, wait a second. You mean I don't have to go out and buy my own shoes? And Kevin, you can have as many pairs of shoes as you would like.
The East up 111-99. And Jordan running into Sprewell, committing the foul. Michael Jordan with his third foul. Well, there's Steve Cyber Snapper Jones conducting a cybercast of tonight's game on NBA.com, the official website of the NBA. Gary Payton getting the roll. And they'll have plenty more from the All-Star Game, including audio and video highlights, interviews after the game. Plus, you can vote for the greatest moment in NBA history, all at www.nba.com. Coming up in 5 minutes, remaining of the fourth quarter, the East up by 10 points. Garnett steps back and comes up short. Scottie Pippen back on the floor, eluding Kevin Garnett and popping the three. Leitner on the save.
I am shocked that Glenn Rice has not gotten back in this game.
Well, perhaps Wilt did have a little conversation with Doug Collins. Hardaway for three. And who's going to say no to Wilt? And that was assist number 9 for Michael Jordan. And Sprewell is fouled. And now Glenn Rice making his way to the scorer's table. 20 points for Rice in the third quarter, an NBA All-Star game record. A look at the shot chart. The red indicating shots made. And he was on fire from three-point range.
Doug Collins just called Michael Jordan over and whispered in his ear, and he probably told him two things. Glenn Rice is 3 points away from tying a record. You are 2 assists shy of the first triple-double in All-Star history. Take care of business. Like you know.
Now, it should be pointed out, Sprewell, these are not occurrences that take place during the course of the regular season. But the fact that things have been on the loose side in All-Star play, the stats do become of significance, and they are being passed on. The East is up by 10. Jordan, 1 assist away from the first ever triple-double in an NBA All-Star game, and Rice 3 points away. And record for most points in a half that is held by the combination of Will Chamberlain and Tom Chambers. Here's Jordan with an opportunity. There it is. Triple-double from Michael Jordan. The first ever in the history of the NBA All-Star Game. His 10th assist in the game. And here comes Pippen with Hardaway the triple. It is the East 118 and the West 104. 3.5 minutes remaining.
And there's an irony here. If you remember last year, the big controversy in a game between the Orlando Magic and Doug Collins' Detroit Pistons, when Anthony Bowie went to all kinds of trouble in the closing second or two of that game to get a triple-double. Doug Collins very upset about it, but here it is, the record-breaking triple-double assist right there to Scottie Pippen. Michael Jordan in the first half, getting things going for the East when they were over 20 points behind, he started to go to town.
And then as soon as he realized that he had the record and the accomplishment, he quickly committed the foul so Doug Collins could take him out and put Penny Hardaway in.
And you saw the stat line, 26 minutes for Jordan, 14 points, 11 rebounds, 11 assists. And once again, the vote for the All-Star Game MVP should be intriguing. There are several categories. As Hardaway gets a three. There are 9 voters, including NBC Sports, putting a little pressure on the Cleveland Flame Dealers involved. Gatling goes to the left hand. the Akron Beacon Journal, Sports Illustrated, USA Today, ESPN Radio, pro basketball writers, and from the international world of basketball, China, France, and several others. Well, here's Michael Jordan with the assist to Scottie Pippen. And that made for the triple-double, assist number 10 for Jordan. Welcome back to Cleveland. Marv Albert with Bill Walton and Matt Kukas. Here are the MVP candidates the way we see them. Michael Jordan with the first ever triple-double in All-Star history. Glenn Rice with a record 20 points in the third quarter. Terrific all-around game for Penny Hardaway. Bill Walton refusing to take off his 50 greatest jacket.
I am a very proud man.
I know that. All right. MVP vote.
Don't tease me about my jacket now.
I vote for Glenn Rice.
Glenn Rice?
Yes.
Well, Penny Hardaway was close. Jordan was close. But I'm finally going to agree with you.
Oh, that's sad. Matt?
I triple the motion.
All right. Our vote.
What's happened to me?
Unless there is a dramatic turn here, we still have 2 minutes and 54 seconds remaining. And the East leads 121 to 107.
Well, they could get the 14 or 15 point play to get right into it, but
yeah. Terrell Brandon of the hometown Cleveland Cavaliers handling. And here's Rice for three. That would have tied the record for a half.
Is Will down there shaking the basket?
He's over there chattering away.
Chris Gatling with a air ball. Gatling 0 for 6 from the field.
But really, Chris Gatling, Marv, is the most unlikely of all All-Stars. The serious, serious injury that he's recovered from completely, of course. With the brain surgery, with a metal plate in the head from a teenage accident.
He was actually headed to a vacation in Mexico. Shrep was able to put it down. Headed for an All-Star break vacation at the last moment due to injuries, named an All-Star. He said he gladly unpacked the bathing suit. Said he was happy to do it, so he's made the choice Cleveland over Cancun. But just so excited about being tabbed as an All-Star. It's a thrill of a lifetime, Mark. You dream about it. And it finally comes true for just a very select few, and you never forget it. Glenn Rice overall is 9 for 21. Gatling looking for that field goal. Now to 135 remaining in the fourth. Brandon Heisman. The second half, 1 point away from the All-Star. The East now leads 123-112. Still time for Glenn Rice to pass by Will Chamberlain and Tom Chambers for most points in a half in All-Star play. For the game, he has 24. For the half, he has 22.
Well, after that last timeout, the East has come out on a couple of occasions trying to run a set play for Glenn Rice. Nothing doing, but just on freelance basketball, the fast break, the penetration, Glenn Rice moving without the ball.
Timeout is called. 1:23 left in the fourth.
You're watching the NBA on NBC.
Rashad back at Gundarino. Now, Marv, I just want you to know that everybody has to do their part in breaking records. You know what I mean? I told Glenn Rice that what he had to do to break the record, and Doug Collins is now doing his part because during that timeout, he diagrammed the play to get Glenn Rice open so he'd have a chance to break the record. Marv?
Let's see how this plays out. Rice with 22 in the second half. You see that enormous 20-point third quarter. The record for most points in a half, 23, that is held by Wilt Chamberlain and Tom Chambers. That is an All-Star play.
And if all that fails as far as getting a set play, Glenn could do what the East did to get back in his game in the first half, just basket hang.
All right, here's Pippen. Rice is down low, being watched by Schrepp. Trying to set Rice up. Here it is. Has the open shot. He had the open shot. Now, through an air ball, he'll say it's an assist. The pass, as Baker was able to put it home. He's working on his own triple-double. So the East now leads 125-112 with a minute five to go. This Gatling with his first field goal.
It's amazing to see Rice's numbers, though, just with 20 of them in one quarter, just 2, 2, and 0.
Now Garnett is guarding Rice.
Get out of his way and let him go.
And let's see, last touched by Garnett, off the foot of Garnett. Down to 51 and 4/10 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. Again, they look for Rice. And here he goes, off the pitch. And Baker is stopped, he's fouled.
These guys who are getting the offensive rebound, they need to bring it back out and feed Rice one more time.
Well, looking a little nervous. Very puzzling news. I mentioned earlier the ballot as you take another look of Rice getting the step and then the foul on Baker. A French newspaper taking part of the MVP voting and the votes coming in. They voted for Jerry Lewis. 42 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter, and the East is up 127-114. Uncontested.
They're just shadowing Glenn Rice with Garnett. Garnett is not even taking his eyes.
Oh, Brandon just fires it up. And the entire East bench looking at Jarrell Brandon. They couldn't believe he took the shot. 131-16 over fans here. London Payton right back down to 20 seconds. Rice guarded by Garnett. Brandon now trying to get him the ball. Rice being held.
Are they going to put him on the line?
So the foul on Garnett.
8 seconds.
Jordan is saying three, but what was that?
Right. West over the foul of it. So here is Rice at the line. An excellent free throw shooter. 86%. He can do it right here. First appearance at the line tonight. And that ties the record.
Oh, Will. You tell him, Marv.
Will Chamberlain, Tom Chambers, Len Rice. In the record books at the moment together, 23 points, most points in a half in All-Star play. And this is number 24 for the half, and that is a new All-Star game record. Final seconds in what has been one of the most entertaining games in many years. Payton with the slam. Payton with 17, the East 132, and the West 120. Here's Brandon looking for another shot to end it for three. So the final, the East 132 and the West 120. The East has won three of the last four. Rice finishes with 26 points, 24 in the second half, a new All-Star game mark, and the first ever triple-double accomplished by Michael Jordan. 14 points, 11 rebounds, 11 assists. We will have the announcement of the Most Valuable Player Award in just a moment. And now look at that free throw by Glenn Rice. As we mentioned, very fine foul shooter, 86%. Conley went to the line, hit 2 of 2 to set the the reaction from Wilt.
Time to write another book, Wilt.
Well, his teammates were trying to set him up. Some had other thoughts on the matter, but Rice did break the record. Let's go over to Ahmad Rashad. Ahmad?
All right, thank you, Marv. It is now time to make the presentation for the 1997 NBA All-Star Most Valuable Player Award. And to make that presentation, the commissioner of the NBA, David Stern.
It was a weekend for the ages. Thank you, NBA's greatest.
Thank you, Cleveland and Northeastern Ohio. Thank you, NBA All-Stars, the world's best athletes and the world's best players. And thank you, Glenn Rice, 1997 All-Star Game MVP, setting a record for the most points in a quarter and a half. Jack Greenberg, chairman of McDonald's USA, is going to help me present the trophy.
Thank you, David. Congratulations, Glenn. It's been a great year for McDonald's and the NBA. Our All-Star crews assisted our customers across the country in voting a record-breaking 9 million times during the McDonald's All-Star balloting. And it's really with great pleasure, on behalf of our 2,700 owner-operators and 12,000 restaurants, to participate in making this presentation the Most Valuable Player Award. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much. Hold it up, guys.
All right. Glenn, it had to be special to be the most valuable player in a game like this with all the 50 greatest players in the stand. I mean, you've really had your peers watching.
It was very special, man. You know, I just got to give thanks to God, first of all. And my teammates really did a great job in trying to get me this award today.
All right, congratulations to you.
Thank you, Rick.
All right, back to you, Marv.
Thank you, Ahmad. Glenn Rice of the Charlotte Hornets winning the Most Valuable Player Award in this year's All-Star Game. What a performance in the second half for Rice. Again, the final score, the East 132, the West 120. Tonight here on NBC, who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of man? The Shadow knows. Alec Baldwin stars in the movie blockbuster, The Shadow. From Matt Dukas, Bill Walton, Mahd Rashad, Jim Gray, and Bob Costas, I'm Marv Albert saying thanks for tuning in. We say goodnight from the Gund Arena in Cleveland. This has been the NBA on NBC.
The NBA, the NFL, Major League Baseball, Notre Dame Football, the PGA Tour, Wimbledon, the USGA Championships, and the 2000 and 2002 Olympic Games, all on America's sports leader, NBC.